The Lord your God commands you to love him and to serve him with all your heart and soul. If you obey him, he will send rain at the right seasons, so you will have more than enough food, wine, and olive oil, and there will be plenty of grass for your cattle. But watch out, you will be tempted to turn your backs on the Lord, and if you worship other gods, the Lord will become angry and keep the rain from falling. Nothing will grow in your fields, and you will die and disappear from the good land that the Lord is giving you. Memorize these laws and think about them. Write down copies and tie them to your wrists and your foreheads to help you obey them. Teach them to your children. Talk about them all the time, whether you're at home or walking along the road or going to bed at night or getting up in the morning. Write them on the door frames of your homes and on your town gates. Then you and your descendants will live a long time in the land that the Lord promised your ancestors. Your families will live there as long as the sky is above the earth. Those words come from Deuteronomy chapter 11, verses 13 to 21. Today is the first day of February in 2014. And there is a very serious drought underway in California. One report says that 2013 was the state's driest calendar year since records started being kept, and this year is heading in the same direction. And yet we stubbornly refuse to look to the Creator of the earth itself for any help. God says that He is the one who can send the rain or withhold the rain, and that he does that in response to the hearts of men. When men love him, serve him, and obey him, the rains come, and they come at the right time. The United States has declared through its laws and courts that we will stand against the laws of God and his desires. We will honor that which he abhors, and we will persecute those he loves. Then we are shocked that we are having such suffering. The difference between Sodom and the United States is growing smaller all the time. And unless we repent, the final outcome is likely to be the same as well. Remember, the mercy of God can cleanse the earth as well as nourish it. Lord Jesus, you have revealed your heart and the holiness and purity that only come from you. We have rejected you and the ways that you teach and still expect you to send the rain. Lord, forgive us, but convict us first of our terrible sin of ignoring your will and your ways. Amen.